Hello. So, I hope my. Not sure if all the tags are put well though. So, yeah, I started drawing this sketch of the two characters featuring. So, feature for the Shinto slash book. It's more like an anime adventure book. This is the fourth illustration, I believe. I think it's the fourth one. So for this illustration, I had to draw, I had to redraw the two girl characters featuring in the book Ayame, and the girl with the armor, and the one that's in the front lit reading this letter. So this is the sketch for now, and the one at the back. Sorry, the one at the back is Tadame, the girl that's with the. She will have a blue dress. So I want to do the line drawing or the line art in the stream and maybe add the basic color. Maybe show a bit how I add the cell shading as well. So the scene is like, I can't give too much spoilers, but you can see from the expressions I tried to make them a bit I don't know. Like a lively expression, but it's more like Tadame. At the girl in the right, she looks a bit uncertain. When Amiya, I'm sorry if I said Ayame, I meant Amiya, so I'm not sure if I said Ayame, I'm sorry. I meant Amiya. I hope I'm pronouncing this right. Amiya looks a bit confused here while reading this letter, and I can't give too many spoilers on the scene, so you guys will need to go check out the book. So the book is called Shinto Slash. This, let's see if I can write it here. Shinto Slash. I can find it on Amazon. Has the I think it has Kindle, it has audio as well. So audio, Kindle, and even we say the actual book. So this will be Kindle, will be digital, audio is also digital, and also the actual book with the cover. So I also did this cover, so actual book, which is like, I'm not sure the page that I remember, it was over. The prologue has, I think, around 200, or if don't remember too well, but you guys can check it on Amazon and you can see all the description. But I think it's over 200 pages, even the first volume. So right now I'm drawing the, I'm redrawing some illustration for the second volume of this book. And if you guys buy the, so I'm not like I'm, I don't, I just want to say that I don't, I'm not paid to talk about the book or anything. I'm only paid to draw the illustration as commissions. But I only wanted to say that you guys, if you want to buy the book, you'll have also a copy of the illustrations that will be in the book. So even the cover, you'll have the finished cover. So I have a complete beautiful cover like this made by me. This is the only part where I show off. So yeah, this is the cover for the second volume, but it will only be out when I finish with all the illustrations. So I'm not sure how many illustrations I need to do. Probably 10 more. I'm not sure. But yeah, it will probably be out by this year anyway. But for now, you cannot go read the first two books that are on Amazon for Shinto Slash. And also, I really suggest you for buy the book and also buy the audio. I mean, and also if you have children like maybe above 13. So let's see. Above 13, right? At least I think it's the sign. So yeah, above 13 years old, they can take the book. I think it's PG-13, right? So they can check the book, they can even read it, I mean. But I think if they check the audio is really immersive and really fun to listen to. It has many effects in the audio, and if you're reading the book, I mean, the kids will love it. PG-13 kids will love it with the audio and stuff. Yeah. Shinto Slash on Amazon, you can find it. And it's also, I think it's cheaper than other books. Also, because it has audio and everything else, so I think it's for the type of, story that it has, like a shonen adventure type of manga with some historical features, and also like oni or demon slayer features. I can also show, but I don't want to give too many spoilers, so I just want to show a bit on the stream the other illustrations that I had to redraw. So I redrew the cover, and this is one of the illustrations that I redrew. Not sure if it can be seen pretty well because it's like a dark scene. So all these here are like the monsters, the oni, demons, Akuma, I guess, and Akuma hidden features here in the corner, right corner, Akuma, and smaller demons like imps, goblins, I don't know, many type of demon, diverse type of demons that the author came up with the idea to make them after some I believe he said warlords, and also like from the Japanese ghost stories. And all these the scene is like the demons are gonna, or the monsters are about to attack the fort here. So it's like a fort, and you can see some archers here. I added some archers here trying to kind of protect the fort. Probably didn't do too well, but yeah, these archers, like, they're here to announce and protect if they can, I mean. But yeah, as long as they can actually kill the imps. They actually managed to kill the imps, I think. Smaller ones that are really, these guys are really dangerous and creepy. So yeah, this was second illustration, I think. And then I have another one that I just finished drawing last week. Yeah, so this is open already now. So here are this where this is another illustration featuring some characters, and it's like it's the type of story that's the scene is happening in the story, so I can't really give spoilers, I'm sorry. But it's again like a very animatic or fun type of scene here. It's a comic scene here that happens in the story. So the characters are like this. The boy on the left is Adachi, with the female character with the armor. She's Amiya, the one I'm drawing now. And behind are the characters on the right, Haruto, the archer. You can see that I drew some. He has the bag with arrows here. And next one, she looks like a ninja or like a shinobi. She's Suzuki. You can see like she's about to laugh at Adachi here. I was like, and they both kind of make fun of them in the back. And this one here is like a little. I believe he was one of the commies though. I'm sorry if I forgot some things. He's gnarly, so he's like a creature commie, I think. So he's also sitting behind, like watching the scene. It's like his eyes here are really glowing from the comic scene that's happening in front of him. And I also tried to make a good background here, like a Japanese type of houses here in the background. And also I tried to make their expression a bit lively, like comic, something funny. Also to give the kids like something fun or comical when they're reading the story, something like that. Yeah, the scene in the story, this scene is actually really funny. And so yeah, I do recommend reading the story. It's not all about violence, or I mean, it's not all action, it's not really violent or anything. So I think it really works for PG-13, like kids over 13 years. That okay. Delete this and I'll start drawing the line art for this. Hello, Lord Baldron on Twitch. I'm not sure if you can still hear my. Welcome to the stream. I hope you didn't left it, because I didn't got the message quite fast on Restream. Just now I see it, because I checked it. Hello, I'm doing good. I'm trying to draw this to finish it. To finish drawing this sketch, so I want to draw the line art now, and I wanted to even try to color. Try to get to the color process in this stream a bit. So these are two characters featuring from the book Shinto Slash on Amazon. I just said earlier if you caught it on the stream, but yeah, for those that want to check the stream again, it's there. It will be also on YouTube. I'll also leave some links below on YouTube for the actual book. The book already has two volumes. It's like the first prologue and volume one. I suggest reading volume one. I think volume one seemed more fun, I guess. The prologue is more like a beginning to everything. So it's a prologue to everything. The way the author wanted to. Also, I don't know, impersonate some or add some historical features in the book. So I'm about to draw some illustrations for that book. So like Kisho again, I think. So she is Tadame, the main character in the book. And Also, I drew some other illustrations that are in the book. So this will be the, let's see if I can find the book cover here. So I tried to make the book cover very dynamic to show the action that will happen in the volume 2. So you can see that most of the characters are trying to fight this monster here. And in the book itself, it's about these characters, main characters, like they're like a team fighting together against the Oni, demons, type of Japanese ghosts. So they all have a different type of power. Yeah, I'm working on the book illustrations right now. This is the fourth illustration that I need to do of this two characters, and I also need to draw a background in the like a background with the forest or something, because they're here on the forest somewhere. They're about to camp. I can't give too many spoilers, but like I said. About to draw this. I can start with the line art now. I try to give the characters a livelier expression. I do might need to edit the sketch a bit. It looks too off for me. Thank you very much for joining, and welcome to. If there's anything you want to ask me, like if I'm drawing, I'm using I'm usually using Paint Tool Sai, and I do have some other live stream drawings that are saved, but on my YouTube channel. My YouTube channel. I'm not sure if the link is still on Twitch. YouTube channel. I'll just leave it here on the chat. Because Twitch usually doesn't save up all the live drawings that I do. They only keep them for 1 week, I think. And YouTube is mainly the other stream channel that I use to keep the live drawing videos, mostly digital. Thank you very much for checking it. I also show process, but I think I showed it on the process of my drawing. I showed it on last year, mainly on some commission drawings. Out there. So I will try to draw some, I mean to do some live streams of these drawings as I go. Don't want to use a less darker color for this. A comic. If you have a dynamic story, like with lots of actions and fighting scenes, yes. Say like the I think everyone knows the Marvel comics. So yeah, probably everyone kind of loves those type of comics where you see actions and characters fighting evil, characters with superpowers or just with I would say martial art. I mean, they can do martial art or stuff like that. So if it's a comic like that, yes. But also, even if it's type of shoujo comic, it's good too. I think you can do. It's more, I don't know, because it has more images, it's more fun to read, I guess. But if you have a story, a longer story type of, I know, that has drama and has maybe type of detective story. If it's more like a novel that has more text, I guess, and more text, the type of description, not type of dialogue, because on comic it will go better if it's dialogue between characters, I think. So if you have a narrative type of story, it's more for the novels, I guess, for type of novels and books. Yeah, novels, I guess, stories, books like that. See. Comics in general, I guess they sell better. I'm not sure though. The comics are like, if you have, if they're the best for children, so it's always the first thing children will buy, because they can see the illustrations, they can see drawings, and it's more fun for them. And also, even the book now, the Shinto Slash book, it does have illustrations. As many illustrations, even in the first prologue, and even in book two, as many illustrations as it is. I think there are over 20 illustrations in the book. So yeah, I do recommend it. Well, yeah, for a comic, you do need maybe to put more work on it, I guess. If you need it, it needs a good artist, so a dedicated artist that really, really loves to draw comics, I guess. The artist will be dedicated to work on the book, on the book illustrations for. The same way as any employer, I guess. 8 hours a day, I guess. I might also need some assistance for drawing background, for drawing mainly pose, I guess. Perspective pose, to give ideas for perspective pose, I guess. Because a main artist can also have some blockage sometimes, if they work too much, I guess. So I need to get better at my inking. Drawing my lines better. I think here in the application that I use in Painter's Eye, I need a better pressure thingy. It is set to stabilizer 13 here. But the pressure still seems a bit. Ah, there I go. Maybe try to lower the density a bit. I can go like this. So the pressure and the lines will be a bit smoother. I myself am not a writer. The book that the writer of the book Shinto Slash is Jericho Black. He's the main writer. I'm only hired as the artist. So if you need what you need to draw. You need to draw fighting scenes or your training. Jericho Black is a writer. So if you're like looking for drawing poses like fighting scenes, most of us artists, I mean, even anime artists now, because we have different references, can find on Google, I guess. There are other websites, even of real humans. We found different types of photos, even. So we mainly draw from reference if it's fight scenes. You can also draw from imagination, of course, if we read the book. But yeah, it also depends if the writer loves the pose, if they agree with the pose. So I myself, I'm not a writer. If I would draw a comic, I would go for maybe type of shoujo. It might seem a bit too off, but yeah, type of shoujo. Manga, I guess, just mild comics with a story, comic story, maybe type of comical story with fantasy, some fantasy features or supernatural features. I would go for that if in this life I might think of drawing one comic. And usually in the comics, I do think that it's not so detailed as books. Sometimes maybe. Maybe the artist can make the exact scene, the exact expression of characters in from imagination. From the scene in the book, but probably books are more detailed if the writer really puts a lot of detail when they write the scene and everything. And fighting scenes especially, I think some writers do add a lot of detail in that. And this is why I think maybe sometimes the scenes in a comic or even in anime shows or in other comic TV shows, or how you say cartoons, yeah, in cartoons, I don't know if they sometimes really put all the like everything in making the full drawing. Yeah, if the studio is really finds the book that good, there can be studios that really put a lot of work in more. Yeah, of course, but there are some studios I think that put a lot of work in expressing everything, I guess I can say that, in expressing the exact fighting scene, the exact emotion of the character during the fighting or during, I don't know, anything, during any type of emotion. Maybe in comics it can't be seen that much. Maybe in animation it can, but in comics. Probably nothing, not everything will be left off, but some parts you might feel that are kind of left off. It's just more like what you enjoy most to read, either comics or novels. I don't know, maybe I can take a actual example here. Twilight. Maybe Twilight, but I don't know, maybe I'll, Twilight fans will hate me. Or the Twilight book. I think it had more detailed. But when you saw the Twilight movie, I'm not sure if it had that, if it really turned out as the book was, or the story in the book was. Some hopefully, yeah, I don't make any Twilight fans angry at me. Oh, you read more novels? Yeah. But novels are like the original, first original thing that the writer actually puts all of his work on. So yeah, I think novels are most original. Even though maybe, I don't know, they just retook one story that they liked and maybe just, rewrote it in their own way or something, but they added more emotions, more drama, more something else. I think there are like the scenes or how you say type of I'm not sure how to call it, to say the writings that are on for scripts, I think it's scripts, the scripts for the theaters, scripts for live action, like in you go to a theater and you see the some scenes from one of Shakespeare books, and maybe the writer. What type of novels do you like the most, like what kind? Like action or like I don't know, adventure novels, fantasy. Did you read Lord of the Rings? Is like that novel out there. I'm not sure if what was it called, Lord of the Rings or The Hobbit, Adventures of the, yeah, Adventures of a Hobbit. What was it, that original title? Lord of the Rings. Cause first. Ah, The Hobbit, yeah. Then there was the trilogy, yeah. Yeah. I haven't read it. I saw some documentaries over it and over the author, and that's how I kind of remembered the bit of it. I saw only the movie. I'm sorry, I didn't read the novel. Actually, I cannot find it here on my own language, Lord of the Rings, because if I would find it, I would read it. And I can't find it in English either. Maybe it's in a bigger city. If I find it in the library in a bigger city, But in the city where I live, I cannot find it. Only if I order it for Amazon or somewhere. The Fellowship, yeah. The Two Towers. Or the Twin Towers, yeah, Twin Towers. And Return of the King. Yeah, now I kind of feel like I want to rewatch the movie. It's also the next movies. They made The Hobbit after that, right? Yeah, the movie and the story, the novel, Lord of the Rings is amazing. So amazing. I hope there will be another movie like that. So, or something like the Chronicles of Narnia or Narnia. I hope there's gonna be another movie like that, or another novel. Or if you know another novel like Lord of the Rings, can you tell me any other, if you read anything like that? I haven't checked lately. I think I only read some shonen manga lately, and I read my friend's novel. Also in Shinto slash there's a lot of fantasy, but it's fantasy like Japanese fantasy, I don't know. Supernatural fantasy in Japanese fantasy, like the type of historical many and superpowers type. How can I say? Something like Yu Yu Hakusho. I think it's the action is more like between Yu Yu Hakusho and Inuyasha. So that type of fantasy. Yeah. With martial arts with superpowers. Yeah, Shinto slash has that type of action fantasy in the novel. Discworld by Sir Terry Pratchett. I'll check it. I'll see if I have it here in the library in my town. Maybe I can lend it and read it at home a bit. Maybe I can read something after all the exams that will finish this summer. Oh, 40 books. 40 volumes of it. Discworld. Amazing, 40 volumes. The author put like every a lot of work, I mean, in writing so much. Writing so many volumes, I mean. Oh, so it's with magic. If it's with magic, I'll look for it. I also did like Harry Potter, so yeah. Yeah, I think I will look for this world. And maybe I can also share it to some children that I know if it's something fun. Can share it here around. Because after Harry Potter, children seem like they're not interested in reading anything anymore. They still read some stories, but it's like meh. I don't know. I mean, I'd try to look for something fun for children to get inspired by to read more. So you say like tomes. It's one of those old type of word for a good book, you know, like tomes. I do prefer children books too. I don't mind a bit of action, but this, I am an adult, and some say that maybe I should read more stories with something that's hap how can I say? Type of stories that are about life or modern world or something like that. It's not that I don't like it, but some stories are just like having too much. Yeah, it's kind of dark. Like in that sense, dark, or they're adding too much. How you say, perverted things. Not perverted, but like violent things. And I'm not the type. I did listen to some audios in that sense, but I don't know if I really enjoyed it. I didn't really enjoy it. I still listen to it just to listen, I guess. It's not like I didn't enjoy it. Didn't really felt like listening to the next volume of that audio story. So I'm not really into modern, I don't know. So I do tend to enjoy more children books like story fantasy, I don't know, some supernatural type of fantasy. Maybe it's some action and just some comic dialogue and stuff like that. I also thought that the last two books of Harry Potter, yeah, the last two books of Harry Potter, they were kind of dark and were a bit hard, even though I like over 20 years, and then still felt like the story felt a bit dark. When I saw the movie, it didn't really felt that dark. Maybe the movie was a bit more like inclined to put some scenes to know that even children are watching this, so guys don't make it too dark. Yeah. Hello. Crack tender man. Hello, welcome to the stream to Enderman on YouTube. Thank you very much for checking my stream. So this is a live stream. I'm trying to finish drawing these two characters for the book novel Shinto Slash. So this is fourth illustrations of a scene from that book, Shinto Slash. Yeah, I guess the last two books, and even the, I think the Prisoner of Azkaban too. It was made to be a bit scary for the audience, I guess. The author, she did mention that it was a bit scary, a bit dark, so she did made it that way for the audience. Nah. I did enjoy the rest of it though, the rest of story. Yeah, maybe just a bit, yeah. But I did enjoy the most of it, most of the book I did enjoy. I just wanted to see what's gonna happen with Harry, with the professors, with the teachers and everything. So I still read it, yeah. But yeah, in a sense, because it's like a school life book, and it's like a school life, but although it's magical school, it's good for, it's made in a way for children. I mean, the first three books there are most likely for children. When I first read it, when I was like, when I was, I think, either 16 or 17. Oh my god, I enjoyed it so much. I couldn't let it go. I mean, when I got two books back at home, The Chamber of Secrets. I know I finished the first book when I was either 16 or 15. It wasn't out yet, the second book. And then the next one, My Country. And then the next year, it was out, both second and third volume. And I landed both home, and I read it. It was really, really enjoyable. Have a little dopamine drop there to remember something nice. Maybe next time I'll put a link on my stream to the book, so who comes in the stream after, I don't know, 1 hour or 2 hours, so they can see the link in the stream for the location of the book or website of the book. I can leave left off to explain all the time since I need to draw. So yeah, I probably need to put the link there. I do also want to try to find that, what say this called? It also was called The Color of Magic and Discworld. So the series is called Discworld, and the first one is called The Color of Magic. Maybe I can try to look for it here. I'm not sure if I'll find it. I'll put it in my put it in my notes. This is not good. The character I'm drawing now, Amiya, she's a girl, but she's a bit tomboyish, and it's a bit. It was a bit harder, difficult to draw her expression as a girl. That's what I think, I guess. But I do. I'm used to drawing like maybe boys with a girly feature. But here, girls with the boyish feature, tomboyish. And in anime style as well, it's a bit. It's a bit hard because if it's anime style, sometimes the girl. It will only look like a girl if it's if she has bigger eyes and like a smaller feature here. So smaller distance between mouth and nose and also eyes, so it will be contrasted in this zone only for girls. For males, the nose will be longer, of course, and the jaw also. But I try to keep the previous artist's render, I guess, the way he drew it, so I tried to keep after their style. Usually my style of drawing girls would be like this, what I drew here of Tadame. So it's kinda this would be my style, I guess.